In this video, I'm going to be testing Starlink in Lagos, Nigeria. I will also be testing it in a more remote area called Ilogbo, about 30 kilometers away from the city itself in Ogun State, Nigeria. This is going to be a detailed review. I'll be taking you through the price of Starlink, the order process, setup, its comparison with other local ISPs, and my thoughts on the service. Hi everyone, I'm Dami, and thanks again for watching this video. Starlink recently became available in Nigeria. And for those who don't know, Starlink is Elon Musk's ISP platform, whose main mission is to provide high-speed, low-latency internet to those people around the world who currently don't have access. For pricing, Starlink costs $600 and a $100 monthly subscription. However, the first month is free. So while trying to order Starlink on the app from Nigeria, the total amount comes $268,584. That number is incorrect. To order from Nigeria, you can only pay with a dollar card. This can either be a virtual card or a bank-issued card, which will bring the amount to 435,000 using the black market rates. As you can see, the kit includes a stand for the dish itself, the router, power cable, and a 75-foot cable. So let's head outside for a quick speed test. To download the app, go to your native app store, iOS or Android, search Starlink and download the SpaceX developed one. All right, so we just got back from setting up. We've also done a quick internet speed test, so you can check out some of the results here. In comparison to our local ISP, so let's head on now for the rural test. So we got to the village, and after a quick setup, we tested the Starlink, and here are the results. As a final note, I will say though that tying back to Starlink's mission of providing internet connectivity to, you know, harder to reach places, that these rural places are oftentimes also financially disadvantaged. So for the people that this product is supposed to be serving, it could be very difficult for them to access this service with the current prices. So while I'm very impressed with the hardware and general product, I also think that there can be some work done to make this product a little more affordable for the people that it's supposed to be serving. So that's it for the review. I hope you found it informative. If you have any questions or comments, please don't forget to drop them in the comments. Like, share, subscribe, you know the vibe. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.